The name of our seventh Imam is Imam Musa ibn Ja'far alayhi salam. He was the son of our sixth Imam, Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam, and Bibi Hamida Khatun. He was born on the 7th of Safar in Abwa, which is a place in between Mecca and Medina. His ignomen is Abu al-Hasan, Abu Ibrahim, and Abu Abdullah, and he enjoys several titles such as Abdul Saleh, Qazim, Bab al-Hawaj, Sabir, and Amin. He excelled in tolerance and forgiveness so much so that he was entitled al-Qazim, meaning the suppressor of anger. He had six brothers, the eldest being Ismail, and nine sisters. He was known for his total submission to the will of Allah, despite the harsh circumstances that Abbasid rulers put him through during his life. It was widely known that Imam Musa alayhi salam had been given powers of healing from Allah, and once he even brought back a dead woman to life. His imamate lasted for 35 years, which was the longest period of imamate held by any of the 12 imams of the Shia Ithna Ashiris. Despite the longest duration of imamate, he was unable to preach Islam like his forefathers did. The oppressive government of Imam Musa's time was pretty strong, and he was constantly being watched by caliph spies out of fear that the imam was raising an army against the government. The imam suffered horrifying and disturbing conditions in multiple prisons that he was put into for 6 years in Basra and Baghdad, the worst and the last being the prison of Al-Sindi bin Shahik. Al-Sindi continuously tortured the imam to such an extent that the imam himself begged Allah to release him from the prison of Al-Sindi. Al-Sindi eventually poisoned the imam on orders from Harun al-Rashid, and the imam's corpse was left on a bridge in Baghdad on Friday, the 25th of Rajab. He was martyred at the age of 55 and was buried in the cemetery of Quraysh. The name of the town itself became Qazimiyah or Qazmin in Iraq.